at Elimination Chamber, I knew how important that match was for Bayley, but at that time, I still was slowly just not.
Where were you happy. Going? What was happening?
Depression. Depression was taking over. My mind was taking over. My thoughts were taking over. This place was being bigger than me. And I really, really lost myself because for a good 7 years, I didn't even hear my real name. I didn't hear Mercedes anymore. All I heard was Sasha Banks. And traveling on the road, we only get 1 to 2 days off. So I'm home, not even seeing what my real hair looks like. All I see is purple hair every single day. There was just so many things that were just, I let it control me. I let it take it in and be like, this is it's too much, instead of being like, you know what? Everything's good. Breathe. Everything's fine.
But does that explain then, you know, the almost 5 months that you were gone from WWE?
I did. I was looking in the mirror, and I was looking at my eyes, and I lost all the light in it. I couldn't even look at myself. I didn't even know who the hell I was, how I was going into work, how angry I was going into, how sad I was. I was not the person that I dreamt to be.
Was it business related or just, was it burnout? Was it fatigue?
Everything.
It was just everything. Hit the fan kind of.
It hit the fan, and I wanted to make sure that I didn't lose myself. So I said, you know what? I got to take a step away and find myself again, and I got to be brave about that. And that was probably one of the hardest things I had to do, was to ask to leave the WWE.
You asked to leave?
I asked to leave.
And what did they say?
Vince was like, no.
Motherfucker always says no.
He said no. He said, I'm going to give you 30 days to think about it. And I took more than 30 days.
Hey, man, I took 6-8 months when I said they wanted me to do some business with a guy that I didn't think the buildup was necessary. And I said, you, I'm out of here.
Yeah.
I didn't handle that in the greatest fashion. So I guess we were in different places, but I've kind of been in the same thing where he's just like, hey, man, I'm gone.
This place can definitely get to you. It's hard.
But in finding Mercedes, you go to Japan to go to a dojo and train with some really talented women.
Yeah.
I almost find it's kind of like interesting because you grew up watching so much All Japan, New Japan, and like if you tell most people that, like, they don't know what All Japan, New Japan is. But if you're a hardcore wrestler, absolutely, you know who and what it is. So you just say, hey, I'm going to Japan. How long did you stay over there? How much did you work out? What was the training?
Yeah, so before WWE, my biggest dream was to be in Japan, but WWE called me first. So when I took my little break, I was like, I'm going to do everything that makes me happy. And I missed wrestling so much. I was like, I'm going to go to Japan. I sent a little DM to Satomura. I'm like, can I train with you? And she goes, yeah, when? I go, maybe next week. Yeah, sure. I go, okay. I just did that stuff. I'm like, I just got to go just for my own soul and just be brave because I wasn't even sure what WWE was going to say about it. But I just was like, it's for me. I had to do it for me.